And maybe the Yankees caught a little bit of a break here, TJ.
I think the Yankees caught a big break. What a play by Derek Jeter. But that ball right there, you see the ball is not in Chuck Knobloch's glove at first base. And Denny Nagel hustling hard down the line was called out, and he was called out because he was a pitcher. If that were a position player, he would be safe, guaranteed.
Knobloch leads it off for the Yankees here in the sixth, guaranteed.
Yep.
Just because he was a pitcher.
Absolutely.
They took him off the base pass so he wouldn't wear himself down or what?
No, the pitcher isn't supposed to hustle like that. He isn't supposed to run fast. He isn't supposed to have a good eye at the plate and take the ball just off the plate. Pitchers get called with strikes more than what the batters do.
Two balls and a strike. The Nagel line, five innings and only one hit.
And the three walks were in the last inning.
Yeah, and the Yankees didn't score. Up high, and he has appeared to have lost the strike zone. Now, it's three balls and a strike now to Knobloch. But he struggled in the last inning and struggling here now.
Denny Nagel had 14 balls going into last inning. During last inning, he had 15 balls just in the fifth inning.
Another leadoff walk by the Yankees. Tim Raines led it off with a walk in the fifth. And that'll take the hat off from Bobby Cox as he'll scratch his head because this is a guy that doesn't walk any guy.
That's why Bobby's hair is starting to get a little gray, but I imagine that's why he has it cut short, too. He just sits there and doesn't pull at it. Leo rocks a little bit more. Pitchers get in trouble. Rocks a little bit more.
And Jeter will step in. Jeter 0 for 2. He's flying out both times.
You know, the thing about it, he's just missing early in the count, and then it seems like as the count goes deeper, he starts missing higher and outside, but that pitch right there was relatively close. It was just a shade low.
Okay. Is this an indication now that Nagel could be getting tired? Missing up high?
If I'm the pitching coach, I've got somebody up in the bullpen.
Well.
If I'm Bobby Cox.
Now you've got a weakened bullpen. You're a bullpen by committee. Are you going to stay with your starter a little bit longer? Probably so. Pretty tough call for the manager, I would think.
That's why those guys get paid big bucks.
You and I are up here speculating. We manage all the time, and we don't make any money, hardly, doing it. But we love to talk about it.
Well, that's why baseball is so great, because there are no football lingo. There's no flanker backs and all this. Everybody's played baseball, and somebody that, well, he should be getting somebody up right now. Anybody knows this. What's Cox doing, or what's Joe Torre doing?
But still only one base hit in the game by the Yankees. And that's out of play.
Denny Nagel giving a little, like a little cock towards first base, trying to freeze Chuck Knobloch. Somebody in his contortion act.
That's the only left-hander down in that bullpen, John Rocker. That's inside. And it's 2-2 now to Jeter.
They got disenchanted with Alan Embry, the other left-hander. They shipped him off for Russ Springer. And now Rocker's down there, and Rocker can throw. I mean, I saw him pitch earlier this year when he was at Richmond. He can blow.
2-2 pitch up high. Now it's ball 3-3-2. So nobody out. Knobloch on at first base. No score.
You ever have a slow leak in a tire and it just kind of starts going flat?
Many a time.
Denny Nagel's got a slow leak in him right now, and he's starting to go flat. Bobby Cox is trying to spur him on. You saw him clapping right there.
The runner takes off, and the pitch is fouled back and out of play. And the Yankees, an offensive ball club that really make you work for that strike, because they're a contact hitting ball club. Don't swing at many pitches out of the strike zone.
They take a lot of pitches. They are not wild swingers, and as a result, Chris Chambliss, one of the better hitting instructors, 2-2, a lot of 2-2 counts, a lot of 3-2 counts.
Runner takes off again. The pitch is outside, ball four. So Knobloch will be on at second base. Jeter will be on at first, and the first two men reaching base via the walk off of Nagel. I think Lopez thought he had him struck out.
I think he did too, and Denny Nagel is chirping at Vanover. Really chirping at Vanover, and you see Javi Lopez is upset right there. Denny Nagel's walked five of the last seven hitters he's faced.
And this is a guy that doesn't walk anybody, and that is
that's Mark Hirschbeck. John Hirschbeck's brother is down at second base. After that play, Eric Gregg ran off the field into the Yankee dugout. I think it was time for his Slim Fast drink.
Well, Paul O'Neill will step in now. A great opportunity for the Yankees, and it's going to be a call strike one on O'Neill, who's 0 for 2. Strikeout in the first, and in the fourth inning, he grounded out. Yankees with only one base hit, but they had three men on back in the fifth. They've got their first two men on here. And Lopez will keep it in front of him. That'll freeze the runner. So it's a one ball, one strike count to O'Neill. Talking to Paul O'Neill, we'll see Knobloch down in a second. They're the runners. But talking to O'Neill before today's game, we talked about him being in kind of a hot streak. And I asked Paul about that, and he said, really, you know, it's not a hot streak for me. And you know, he's pretty hard on himself. Unless he is getting a base hit every time, it's not a good streak for him.
Paul O'Neill is the Andy Pettit of hitters.
Outside, 2-1. Hard on himself.
That pitch right there was a pretty good pitch. And because Lopez and Nagel have been jawing at Vanover, it just got a little cotton strike zone right there. Like you got a cotton shirt and you wash it in hot water and it shrinks. That strike zone is shrinking a little bit right there.
A good swing, but foul back and out of play. So the count now, two balls and two strikes.
I'll tell you one thing as a pitcher you don't want to do, Bob. And you know it as a, if you get that guy in blue back of the plate a little upset at you, it can go either way. As a pitcher, boy, you've got to groove it. And as a hitter, that strike zone expands.
Well, on the way this game is going, any little thing could mean the difference in this game.
Absolutely.
2-2 pitch, and that appeared to be a hanging breaking ball for O'Neill, and he fouls it back out of play. He knew he had a good pitch to hit there, and he fouled it back. He is really mad at himself.
Something up and out over the plate that he could get that top hand down on, and he just was a tad bit late.
You know, he turned around and asked Lopez, was that a strike? You were talking about Russ Springer. He is now warming up for Atlanta.
But Nagel cruising along for four innings, and then all of a sudden in the fifth, three walks. Two more right here, and he's got himself in trouble with a hot hitter at the bat. But believe me, I know what it's like. 2-2, you've lost the strike zone, you have no clue, and you've got a good hitter at the plate, and you're hoping that you can make a quality pitch and that he will not hit the ball hard someplace.
Well, this is the battle that baseball is made of. And the circle change is down low and outside. It's ball three, 3-2. Nobody out, two men on.
Nagel has, you know, relatively high leg kick, and he kind of tucks his arms in, and you see him tuck his shoulder. And there's the circle change, and you see him take that ball, and on the circle change, he cups his arm more than he does with his fastball, almost like you're taking and dropping a ball with your wrist bent, a limp wrist.
We'll see what the runners do with nobody out. They take off, and the pitch is lined in the gap right center field. Knobloch will score easily. They'll wave Jeter around third. He'll come on and score. O'Neill will take it to third for a triple and a triple. Two RBIs for Paul O'Neill. The Yankees take a 2-0 lead.
Having the runners go 3-2, nobody out, tells you what kind of a hitter Joe Torre thinks Paul O'Neill is. A lot of managers will not let them go with no out because you can hit into a double play. Fastball out over the plate.
And he couldn't afford, TJ, to make too good of a pitch on O'Neill. Otherwise, he's got the bases loaded. Martinez coming up, so he had to put the ball in play. Infield will come in now for Martinez. First pitch swinging. Pops it up. Shallow center field. I don't know if it's deep enough. O'Neill tagging. And Jones with a strong arm in center as O'Neill will hold at third. So a missed RBI by Tino Martinez. And there's one gone.
Tino swung at the first pitch. And he swung really at a pitch that was out of the strike zone. Just got a little over anxious, wanting to drive that run in, saw the infield in. See the ball up a little bit. And just got underneath it. And Tino knew he swung at a bad pitch, and that wasn't his pitch to drive.
O'Neill now with 55 runs batted in. And the Yankees have still another opportunity with only one out. The infield will still come in. Leading the American League in RBIs is Juan Gonzalez with Texas, 93.
Well, I was going to say he's only 40 behind the leader.
How about that?
And 55 is pretty good at All-Star break.
Give me 55 in a year. How about 93? And we're not even to the halfway point. Pitch on a 2-0 count, and it's 2-1.
Eric Gregg's back out on the field, just had to take a little pit stop, go in, get new tires.
Hit hard and pass. Raffanino in the right field for a base hit. The Yankees will make it 3-0 as O'Neill comes on to score. So some timely hitting by this Yankee ball club with the best winning percentage in baseball. You don't make mistakes against a good ball club.
You don't make a lot of mistakes against a good ball club. And with the infield in, that ball with the infield back, that's a ground ball, that's an out. But with the infield in, Graffanino had no chance to catch that ground ball.
Now, mistakes that I'm talking about is the fact that Nagel got himself into trouble by walking the first two men, which is totally uncharacteristic from Denny Nagel. Now Chad Curtis will try to get his first base hit. He's 0-for-2.
That was Denny Nagel's 100th pitch, and he was cruising along the first three or four innings. Had hardly any pitches. Now Leo Mazzoni coming out and wants to talk to his left-hander.
Well, it's one of those nights. It's hot and muggy and hazy here in Atlanta, Georgia. But on the other hand, for Bobby Cox and his starting crew and the way his bullpen is set up now, sometimes I think you just stay with your guys that gotten you where you are a little bit longer, knowing that maybe the best is out there right now.
Well, that's what's happened to Bobby Cox and the Braves in years gone by. they haven't had a good middle relief corps out of their bullpen. And they stay with the starters 7-8 innings, pitching into the ninth inning, wanting to get to Wohlers, their closer. And as a result, their bullpen doesn't get a lot of work. Then when they get into playoff games, they're like kind of hamstrung because their pitchers are not really ready, and that's not the strong part of their bullpen. So actually, the starting pitchers are really a reason why they don't have a real strong bullpen in the middle, because they never get to them.
Outside now, Nagel has fallen behind Curtis. Two balls and no strikes.
Nagel came in and gave Vanover a hard look. That ball a few innings ago was a strike. But when you show the umpire that you cannot throw a strike, or you're having trouble throwing a strike, and you make that perfect pitch out there, you don't get that call. That's why Greg Maddux gets all the strikes.
Holy cow, this is gone. 2-0 pitch into left field. Home run, Chad Curtis. Chad's seventh home run, and the Yankees will take a 5-0 lead. I mean, when it left the bat, it was gone.
Bobby, Chad Curtis got a 2-0 fastball up and out over the plate, and he just hammered it. Absolutely hammered it. Watch the ball out over the plate. That ball went 15 rows deep, 20 rows deep. Boy, that was
the kind of swing by a hitter that really feels good when it leaves the bat. And the Yankees are feeling good. They lead it 5-0. We'll be back right after this.
CRV from Honda with real-time four-wheel drive. Don't keep it cooped up too long.
Go, baby, go! Go, baby, go! Yeah! What?
Come on out to Belmont Park for the most exciting ride in sports. Racing Wednesday through Sunday, post time 1 p.m. The New York Racing Association at Belmont Park. What a ride.
Having fun yet?
Then get to the summer of fun and nobody beats the Wiz. Buy the fun stuff you want and get more fun stuff, like special offers, tickets to games, Madison Square Garden, Radio City Music Hall. With select purchases, see newspaper for details. Nobody beats the Wiz, a Cablevision company.
Chrysler in Plymouth announces the Owner's Bonus Sale. These unbeatable savings are also extended to all GM and Ford owners. Select customers save $2,000 on Plymouth Neon. Save $2,000 on Chrysler Cirrus. And save $1,500 on Chrysler Sebring Coupe and $500 on Sebring Convertible. And when you choose our low APR rate, you still get the extra $500 owner's bonus. The Chrysler in Plymouth Owner's Bonus Sale. For a limited time only at your Chrysler in Plymouth dealer.
Well, here in the top of the sixth inning, the Yankees have put 5 on the board. They lead it 5-0. Chad Curtis, when you're in New York, stay at the Southgate Tower, where you can get a spacious suite for the price of an ordinary hotel room. Call 1-800-MESUITE. And after that home run, you can relax in a beautiful suite. Boy, take a look at this. Is this pretty or what?
Just got everything into it. But that was a good pitch and a good count to hit the ball that far. 2-0, fastball up and out over the plate.
Well, the new pitcher now is Russ Springer, and Scott Brosius is the batter. I don't care if you're one of the better pitchers in baseball or if you're the worst pitcher in baseball. As we take a look at Russ Springer's numbers just over from the Diamondbacks for that trade. When you walk people, if they're going to turn around, it'll always haunt you.
Absolutely. Whether it's a it just seems like walks, they're going to score the majority of the time, but actually it's only about 40% of the time. Whether it's a walk, a base hit, an error, whatever, you got to keep people off the bases. And then when they walk, you've not given your defenders a chance to catch the ball.
Popped him up shallow center field. Andrew Jones calling off Graffinino. So two outs now here in the sixth inning for the Yankees. That'll bring up Girardi. Well, the American League East standings and the Yankees with a 10-game lead over Boston. With that best winning percentage in baseball. And Girardi sends one off to the right side off of Springer. Springer's a former Yankee. Signed and played with the Yankees back in 1992. He's also played for California, Houston, and then was selected in that expansion draft last year. That's out of play. Now it's no balls, two strikes to Girardi. Corner strike three on the 0-2 pitch. But the Yankees do big damage here in the sixth inning. After the leadoff walks, the Yankees come up with five, highlighted by Chad Curtis's two-out home run.
The most award-winning brand of 4x4s has done it again. Presenting Jeep Grand Cherokee, just named Best Sport Utility. And now you can lease the leader with a special $319 a month leadership lease or get 1.9% financing. Grand Cherokee, highest in owner loyalty, and now named Best Sport Utility. No wonder year after year, Grand Cherokee always winds up on top. Check out this $319 lease at your dealer.
Troy Aikman is back to pass. He's looking, looking, look out. Oh, Aikman goes down.
He had a man wide open. What was he thinking?
Brute, it's all part of the game.
All right, guys, same play.
Where can I get Bell Atlantic mobile wireless service? I know I saw a store around here somewhere. Wait a minute. I can go to any Nobody Beats the Wiz location. That's where I can get the best wireless values in New York and New Jersey. Like Digital Choice Service, with the first incoming minute of every local call free. Plus, unlimited night and weekend local airtime is free for 1 year. And I know there's a store right over here.
Bell Atlantic Mobile Service is now at Nobody Beats the Wiz, a Cablevision company.
Your dog, your couch, your toaster, your shoes, your girl, your dinner, your souvenir, your lamp, your seventh grade teacher, your seventh grade fantasy, your soccer ball, your shower curtain, your TV, your sex, your paperweight, your goldfish, your job, your sunglasses, your relationship, your kid's sister, your trash, your life, your car. The Honda Civic, it has you written all over it. Now you can get 3.9% APR for 36 or 48 months on all 98 Civics.
Well, bottom of the sixth coming up, only four hits by the Yankees, but they come up with five runs. They now lead 5-0. And if you've got plans for the 4th of July, maybe you want to change them, because the WB11's got the whole thing planned for you. We've got the Bronx Bombers against Baltimore, then the Macy's Fireworks Spectacular, and then the first ever viewer-chosen Classic Trek Marathon. It can't get any better than that. So mark your calendars now and plan to spend your July 4th weekend with the WB11. Talking about fireworks, TJ, how about this piece of Roman candle work?
Well, I know you hitters like to see that, and as a pitcher, that's the worst sound, that resounding crack.
That took off like a Roman candle, didn't it?
By heaven's sakes.
Boy, the quiet man does it again.
Just goes along and does his job, yep. And doesn't just, you know, just here I am. Two RBIs, got 33 on the season, seven home runs.
Ozzie Guillen leads it off for the Braves here in the sixth inning. And Guillen 0 for 2 tonight. Guillen, better known for his career with the Chicago White Sox. Now it's 1-1. Ozzie, an ever talkative guy. He loved to talk. And he was having some fun with Dom Zimmer, Jose Cardinal, and Jorge Posada before today's ball game over towards the Yankee dugout. Good breaking ball in there for a call strike. Now it's 1-2. We take a look at our Nobody Beats the Wiz scoreboard. Now Baltimore leading the match 2-1. That's in the seventh inning. And Milwaukee over Minnesota. Cleveland 6-2 over St. Louis. I don't know if McGuire's hit any home runs in that game. Well, David Wells, he's swinging the bat, and he is playing some pretty darn good defense. Good pickup by him. One gone.
That was a real good play by David Wells. If he missed the ball, Scott Brosius had it right in back of him. But he broke Ozzie Guillen's bat. David Wells bounced off the mound pretty good. Got himself righted and threw a strike to first base.
There's no wobbly legs there, which is a clear indication that you could be getting tired.
Well, that's the one thing that's why you do your running. That's why you do your leg lifting in the weight room. You keep those legs strong and you can withstand some heat like this.
And Gerald Williams goes after the first pitch. High fly ball, shallow center field. Curtis, rightfully so, will call off Knobloch, and he'll make the out. Two gone. Let's take a look again at some more scores on our Wiz scoreboard. Now Florida leading Tampa Bay 5-0. And Boston continues to put pressure on the Yankees, even though the Yankees have a 10-0 lead. I mean, they're the only ones really winning in the American League East. Chipper Jones now stepping in.
David Wells starting this inning had 70 pitches. The inning before, in the fifth inning, he threw just 7. And he has gone through these last two innings with very few pitches.
Let me ask you something, TJ, on a guy like Chipper Jones. You know, he's a quality hitter. He's got 18 home runs. They've all come from the left side. Doesn't have power from the right side. Wouldn't you want to pitch him up in the strike zone if you knew that and let him hit the fly ball to center field?
If I were a fly ball pitcher like David Wells, if I were Tommy John.
Let him hit the ball in the air.
If I were Tommy John, I've never seen a guy hit a home run on the ground.
Well, I know your style was the sinker ball, obviously, but
Ron Guidry could pitch like that. Throw him up and out over the plate and let him hit big fly balls, especially in a big ballpark.
But the reason I bring that up, you know, for our young viewers, our potential professional players out there, these are little things that you can look at and take advantage of, I think. If David Wells knows that, he pitches up the strike zone, let him hit the ball in the air in the center field. Percentages are saying he's not going to hit the ball out of the ballpark and he's not going to hurt you.
Well, that's one way, and I think the other way is, as a pitcher, you pitch your way and make the batter adjust to you. If Chipper Jones is going to hit the ball out of the ballpark right-handed, it's going to be something about belt high on the inside half of the plate.
Pretty good pitch by Wells. It's a little bit too high.
Bobby, that's the pitch David Wells. I love that pitch off him because it's the old-fashioned curveball. It's not a slurve. It's not any. It's just a big 11-5 curveball, and David thought he had it right there, but it was just a shade high.
Off-speed pitch in line over the outstretched glove of Jeter in the left field. Two-out base hit for Chipper Jones. Came back with the breaking ball, only it was a little bit slower breaking ball that time.
That was almost the same pitch that he took for ball two, and that ball Chipper, you saw him just kind of bail out, got the bat head out on the ball. And Derek takes one step and a jump, and just a little over his glove. What, that was a good
Looked like a Michael Jordan leap there at shortstop.
Well, Bobby, you were a shortstop when you first came in, and you jumped like that.
Absolutely. I used to jump like that all the time. I was getting out of the way of people throwing things at me in the stands. Javi Lopez swings. That was the first pitch out of play off to the right side. And a couple of pitchers used to hurl a few things at me out there, too. You would have loved a guy like me, TJ. Ground ball pitcher. Stottlemyre.
Took you out to dinner all the time.
I played shortstop behind Mel. He loved me. Just ask him. Off the end of the bat, hit pretty hard into right field for a base hit. Chipper around second. He'll end up at third. So the Braves here in the bottom of the sixth inning with two outs have two men on.
You know, David was rocking along. A nice little comebacker, and then a fly ball, and a base hit, and another base hit. And now you've got yourself Andrew Jones up. That's a pretty good pitch. Outside part of the plate. Up in the strike zone. And that's the one thing, when you keep the ball on the ground, if that ball is 3 feet closer to Chuck Knoblauch, it's catchable, and you're out of the inning.
Well, that's going to bring, or is it going to bring, Stottlemyre out to the mound. He was on his way out there. And what happened? He was on his way out. Or it appeared that he was on his way out.
I don't know, but
nevertheless, Andrew Jones is the batter with two men on and two men out. Popped him up right side. Will it stay in play? And Andrew took a shot at our cameraman down towards the Atlanta dugout. That's Wayne, one of our camera people.
You guys got to wear hard hats over there if you
do. That's a hard hat.
That's a hat's got some pine tar on it, too. That looks like one of Ozzie Guillen's when he had it over it with the White Sox.
It looks like it's got some kind of a skin rash or something on it. That'll be out of play off to the left side. Graham Lloyd now begins to warm up for the Yankees. I don't think Nelson is available tonight. Mike Stanton is still available. His appeal will come up tomorrow in New York. So in a hearing with the American League. That's the 8-game suspension appeal for Mike Stanton.
Now, who argues that appeal? Do the Yankees?
Players Association.
Players Association. Gene Orza?
I guess. I guess you could have your own lawyer there if you wanted to argue the appeal for you, but I think the Player Association normally does that for the player. Joining Lloyd in the bullpen is Ramiro Mendoza. So Lloyd, the left-hander, Mendoza, the right-hander, warming up for the Yankees. Two outs, a 1-2 count to Jones, Andrew Jones, that is, and two men on for the Braves. And the breaking ball this time will strike out Andrew Jones. So a quality pitch made by David Wells. The Braves will leave a couple of men on. Top of the seventh coming up. Yankees lead it 5-0.
I saw a picture of it on the internet, and I was like, wow. The accent had a lot of power. They say that in all the commercials, but it's so fun to drive. I feel really safe in my car because it has the dual airbags, side impact protection.
Get the Accent with stereo cassette starting at $7,349.
Value is getting what I want for what I want to pay. If you drive the car, you're definitely going to become a Hyundai believer. I am.
How far can you go on a tank of Mobil Super Plus? How about London? or Rio, or any of the over 250 destinations that American Airlines flies to worldwide. Every time you fill up with Mobile Super Plus, you can pick up a game packet that includes 100 AAdvantage miles and the chance to win a grand prize of air travel for a whole year. So fill up with Mobile Super Plus. Play, take wing, and take off.
I believe I can fly.
Both these men have athlete's foot, but only one used the soothing cure. Prescription strength Desinex. It calms the itching and cools the burning while it heals. Got athlete's foot? Get Desinex, the soothing cure.
My idea of an American beauty? My Chevy Malibu. It's spacious, reliable, and costs over $2,000 less than Camry or Accord. I shop Chevy and I leased it for $219 a month for 36 months with a $1,204 initial payment. I got air, automatic, ABS. Oh, and get this. My Malibu won't need its first scheduled tune-up for 100,000 miles. This is the car you knew America could build. Hey, for $219 a month, I got a piece of the American dream.
Lease a Malibu for $219 a month or buy and get 1.9 financing. Shop Chevy now.
5-0, the Yankees lead it. Top of the seventh coming up here at Turner Field. We want to remind you that you could catch the action when the Yankees close out their interleague schedule against the Phillies with three games on Tuesday, June the 30th, Wednesday, the July the 1st, and Thursday the 2nd. All games at 7:30, and tickets are available now at the stadium and through Ticketmaster. And David Wells kicking that right leg up, and he was getting ready to dugout. He's putting all the batting gloves on. He's seen a lot of the hitters prepare themselves to come to the plate. That pitch is fouled back on a play. Now it's 0-2. The hands are wet. Either that or the gloves are small. He's trying to hurry. Get the equipment. Let's go. He's had some pretty good cuts at the pitches tonight. He's got a base hit. Back in the third off a Nagel.
I don't think David Wells has a t-shirt on. I think he's gone in and just taken everything off, and it's bare skin. No, there is a t-shirt right there. I see it. It's open.
Same color as the uniform.
Usually on a hot night, the sleeves start going, they start pulling down below your uniform top.
Well hit it deep into right field. Going back is Williams, and on the middle of the warning track in right field. One of the deepest parts of this ballpark. 390 out there, and David Wells has hit another one hard. By the time Williams came down with the ball, Wells was at second base. That's how far he hit it.
That's pretty good pitching. And David Wells has had some good swings tonight. Some real good swings.
He's doing it all tonight.
He wasn't even in his home run trot. He was in his double or triple trot.
Well, sometimes you don't know whether you get it or not. Knobloch takes one up high. It's one ball, one strike to Knobloch. He's the guy that got it started for the Yankees in the sixth inning with a leadoff walk. Good pitch by Springer. Now it's 1-2. Well, another sellout here at Turner Field, 49,000 plus. They hold 50,000 plus here, but anywhere around 48 or 49,000, they consider a sellout because of standing room. There's about 3,000 standing room, 5,000 standing room. There's that standing room only out in the outfield. They've got all kinds of things here. They've got a pavilion where they serve food out in right center field. The chop house is out there. Oh, I bet you they sell a lot of beverage here in Atlanta during the summertime. A lot of soft drinks. A lot of water. Now the pitch foul back out of play, so Knobloch hanging tough. One out here in the seventh for New York. 5-0, they lead it.
When I came in early today, I was walking around the concourse, and they have batting cages for the kids. They have pitching cages. They have all things to do out there. I mean, they have a video arcade. If you don't like baseball and mom is there and the kids get a little grouchy, you can go out and play video games or hit the ball and do things. They have a lot of things to do other than watch baseball at Turner Field.
3-2 pitch high and inside, ball four, so Knobloch with another walk.
This copyrighted telecast is authorized under rights granted by the New York Yankees solely for the private non-commercial use of our audience. Any publications, reproductions, retransmissions, or other use of the pictures, descriptions, and accounts of this game without the express written consent of the New York Yankees and WPIX is prohibited.
Boy, you do such a good job. Jeter, who is 0 for 2 with a walk and also a run score. Up high for a ball.
That's a National League ball right there. That was just barely above belt high. But as you find out watching National League games, that more often than not, that is a ball.
Knobloch will take off, and he got a big jump. Off of Springer, no chance for Lopez. Stolen base number 15. Check that. That's number 20, that is, for Knobloch.
Whoa, you saw as soon as that leg went up, Chuck Knobloch took off. Javi Lopez with a real good arm, but there's no way he could even come close to Chuck Knobloch with the jump he got. Derek Jeter got that ball just above the belt, just right almost at the belt, and held off. And don't know if Vanover called that on the swing or the pitch, but I think he could have done either one.
Either one, yeah. Now it's 1-2 to Jeter. Now make a play down at second. Guillen trying to sneak in behind Knobloch. It's good for one shot. After you take that one shot, well, you see Knobloch will took. Turn around and look to see where the infielders are. That'll help him gauge on how far he can get off at second base. Now they'll try again. This time it was a little bit closer.
You know, Bobby, a lot of base runners, Davey Lopes, Morgan, Ricky Henderson, after they steal second, they'll go right on the next pitch and try to steal third. And that was real close.
Knobloch will take off. Lopez's throw is in time. I think Knobloch came off the bag. Well, it was the first pitch after he stole second base, but it was about the second or third attempt that they tried to pick him off down there. I think he wanted to prove something to them.
And he just throwing back there like they did just kept Chuck Knobloch just a little bit from getting that real good jump.
Boy, he makes a heck of a slide here, and I'm not so sure. I'm not so sure if he didn't avoid the tag, but he came off the base pass. Well, that'll end the inning, so the Yankees maintain a 5-0 lead here at Turner Field.
The new Dodge wanted to take the sport utility concept to a higher level. Enter the new Durango. Its best-in-class power, cargo space, and seating for up to 8 raise the bar considerably, as do its strongest-in-class frame and its stable, longer, wider stance. Dodge Durango, a higher form of sport utility. From top to bottom. Durango, new ground for the new Dodge.
Fun yet? Then get to the summer of fun and nobody beats the Wiz. Buy the fun stuff you want and get more fun stuff, like special offers, tickets to games, Madison Square Garden, Radio City Music Hall with select purchases. See newspaper for details. Nobody beats the Wiz, a cable vision company.
Now for a limited time, get a 98 Rodeo for $259 per month for 48 months with $1,553 due at lease signing. Or receive $1,000 cash back with purchase during the Isuzu Go Farther Getaway event. Offer ends June 30th.
Well, back at Turner Field, Bobby Mercer along with Tommy John, and what they do here when they start an inning. The fans here at Turner Field, they give that tomahawk chop, only it's not working tonight for the MTJ.
And it better not work.
David Wells pitches here at the bottom of the seventh inning to Danny Bautista, Ryan Klesko, and Tony Graffanino. I'll tell you what, Wells, for a hot, muggy night, he's still bouncing around pretty darn good. And he's been as active as anybody. He's been on the base pass with a base hit, fielding, pitching.
We said in the pregame, I said five or six innings would be a real good outing, maybe seven. And I think David Wells has just done a masterful job. Absolutely outstanding.
Off the end of the bat. Unassisted play by Martinez, one gone. Well, we talked about the sellout crowd here at Turner Field. A two-day attendance record has been set between the Yankees and this Atlanta Braves ball club, 98,032. Here for a two-day showdown between the Yankees and the Braves. So the interleague definitely is working for the New York Yankees and the Atlanta Braves. Brian Klesko, the batter. Klesko, one for two.
Early in the year, we said David Wells had a little tough time down in Texas on a real, real hot night and kind of got out of gas early. But I'll tell you what, this has just been outstanding. This has been outstanding because even if you throw few pitches, if you're a pitcher that throws 6, 8, 10 pitches an inning, you're still gassed after 6, 7 innings. Well, Mel Stottlemyre's got to be happy.
Well, that's a good swing by Klesko, but if you see, we've had many of shots of David Wells. Stottlemyre has seen it. Joe Torre certainly has seen it. He appears to be having fun tonight.
I think David Wells has fun all the time.
No, but I mean, seriously, he appears to be having fun.
He's out there swinging the bat.
You know, I think a pitcher, when he swings the bat, he feels like he's more in the game. You know, he's a part of the whole process. Quality pitch on Klesko. Now it's 2-2. He hasn't walked a batter, and he struck out four.
He hasn't walked a batter now in two plus games. Didn't walk any his last start. Didn't walk any the start before that.
Whoa, get out of the way. That one got away from Wells, almost hit Klesko.
That looked like a breaking ball that just kind of went up there and spun. And the people booed here, and there was no more intent on that than anything.
Well, you were talking about the walks as we take a look at this pitch again. That certainly wasn't intentional, obviously. That just slipped out of his hands. Wells has not allowed more than one walk in any of his last nine starts, and that's coming into this start tonight. Swing and a miss, strike three, so he strikes out Klesko. Fifth strikeout for the night.
A slider that was up and in, and then he just threw a fastball right on by Ryan Klesko. Ryan wanted to try to get that thing, and you see Ryan yelling and wants to throw his bat because he knew he swung at ball four.
Fanino, who is 0 for 2. The Yankees are 12 and 2 in Wells's 14 starts, and they average almost 7 runs in his starts. Another grounder back to David Wells. And a 1-2-3 inning for David and the New York Yankees. We played 7 here at Turner Field. The Yankees lead it 5-0.
For 1998, the Lexus LS400 has been redesigned with sleeker lines, a more powerful 290-horsepower engine, and a standard vehicle skid control system that helps improve cornering in adverse conditions. Which would appear to put the LS400 in a class by itself. Its value runs circles around the competition at your New York, New Jersey, Connecticut Lexus dealer.
The introduction of Visine revolutionized eye care. Now, there's Advanced Relief Visine. This simulation shows how its moisturizing formula spreads soothing, cooling relief. New Advanced Relief Visine. It gets the irritation out.
What's the best way to deal with obstacles? Eliminate them. That's why Dell deals direct with every customer, so nothing comes between you and exactly what you want. Dell computers with Intel Pentium 2 processors. Got an appetite for success? Be direct, Dell.
Jeep Cherokee has always been the perfect getaway vehicle. But now, look what you can get away with. The $279 a month Jeep Cherokee lease, where you get 190 horses, automatic transmission, and always capable four-wheel drive. Plus now, these extras, including air conditioning at no extra charge. The $279 a month Jeep Cherokee lease. A great deal to get away with when you really want to get away from it all. Check out this $279 lease at your dealer.
New York Yankees baseball is sponsored by Jeep, the most awarded brand of 4x4s on earth. Now, David Wells has done it all tonight, TJ. I don't know if this is going to be his last inning or not. There he is laughing again. I mean, he's having some fun. He is having some just a delightful time tonight, and it may have something to do with that ammonia water. Is that ammonia water? You for sure?
Golly, I hope
they
so.
They have some laughing gas in there. O'Neill, the batter, and Rocker is the new pitcher now for Atlanta.
Big John Rocker, 6'4". See right there, is this his 14th game? Amazingly, a setup guy where you come in and get the one left-handed batter out.
1-1 now to O'Neill. Paul with a big triple back in the sixth inning with two men on. That put the Yankees in front 2-0. Pulled off that one a little bit. That Rocker's got as good a stuff as anybody. I mean, he throws the ball hard. The ball is moving around in the strike zone.
And he kind of drops down a little bit, and that curveball the pitch before fooled O'Neill, and then that fastball, he just threw it right on by him. John Rocker saw him pitch, like I said, in Richmond, and he just blew the ball by the AAA guys.
Ian at shortstop throwing out O'Neill, one gone.
Here comes a two-strike pitch to O'Neill. And that was a little cut fastball or slider, whatever you want to call it. And Guillen comes in throwing off the wrong foot, throws a strike.
Rocker, 6'4", 210 pounds from Macon, Georgia. Born and raised in Statesboro, Georgia, so it's almost like home for him. And as you mentioned, played in the Carolina League. This is Tino Martinez.
Tino struggling with the bat, and then you're out there facing a real tough left-hander. Sometimes that can make you a little more mentally tough. Get you to concentrate a little more on the ball.
Well, I was talking to Shambliss before today's ball game, and we were talking about Tino Martinez, and Shambliss certainly wasn't concerned about the recent somewhat slide by Tino. I think every hitter goes into that, and you got to go back to the time when Benitez hit Tino in the back, and he had to miss a few games. And since that time, Tino really hasn't been the same. He hasn't swung the bat as well prior to that incident. Now he claims that the back is not bothering him now.
But do you think, you know, Tino says that, but deep down you think there might be a little tightness in there that will not let him extend on through?
Could be.
Or cuts the swing off slightly?
Now he talked about that, you know, when he came back after that was, and he got hit again. That got away from Rocker, and that may have hit him in the exact same spot that Benitez hit him a few weeks ago. That was not an intentional pitch, obviously, by Rocker. That got away from him. But watch where it hits him. That's almost the same spot.
And you see Rocker's reaction. That may have even been a breaking ball. Just the way it looked like, the way he turned loose of the ball, that was a breaking ball that hit Tino in the back. That hit him right at the four.
Tino appears to be all right. He's down at first base. And Tim Raines, well, back for the fourth time. He is officially 1-for-2 with a walk. And Bobby Cox struggling now with his ball club. The Braves came in with a 7.5 game lead over the New York Mets. So the Yankees doing favor for the Mets. And now the Yankees could do some favor for Atlanta as they move back to New York tonight to start that three-game series against the Mets at Shea Stadium. Right side, Graffinino's only play is to throw out Raines at first, so Martinez will end up at second. Now we talked about the three-game series coming up between the Yankees and the Mets. It begins tomorrow at 7:30, brought to you by MSG. Their pregame starts at 7 o'clock on MSG. All the guys will be there from MSG. David Cone will return home, basically. It'll be an exciting time. You talk about Shea Stadium, it will be rocking. Strawberry will be there. Strawberry back against the Mets for the first time. And capacity crowds expected, sell out for a three-game series. And I'll guarantee you it will be the talk of New York for at least 3 days. It has been for the last about the last 7 days. And Chad Curtis steps in. Curtis hit a monstrous two-run home run in the sixth inning off of Denny Nagel. That drove him out of the game.
You know, the thing that makes it that makes that series even more exciting is the Mets have a pretty good ball club. They have real good pitching, and they have a legitimate chance to get into the wild card race.
Well, the Mets coming into tonight's game Their record 41-32. As I mentioned, 7.5 games back of Atlanta and the National League East. Bobby Cox talking to him about interleague play, and he said, what I like about it is, he says, you know, it really is fun for us because we get a chance to play the American League East. And he said that's where the tradition is. I mean, that's where all the great ball clubs are, and we get a chance to face all those guys. But like everybody else, he says these two game series are killing us.
Yep.
So they've got to do something about that.
I cannot believe they could not come up with something better than this.
Well, they're going to talk about it after the season is over with, and hopefully they, if they continue interleague play, that'll be a subject of conversation. They will try to see how they can better the schedule and maybe do away with these two game series. Just to update you, the Mets now have tied Baltimore in the eighth inning. It's 2-2 at Shea. And speaking of 2-2, two balls, two strikes, two outs. Chad Curtis at the plate, one man on, and the Yankees in front 5-0. Hit hard down the right field line. Tough play for Gerald Williams as he drops the ball, banging up against the right field wall. Martinez will come on to score. The Yankees will take a 6-0 lead. It appeared that Gerald Williams had the ball in his glove, and then he banged up against the wall and dropped it.
He had the ball and hit the wall, and it's up to the discretion of the scorer to either a hit or an error.
Let's give him a hit. I think he hit it hard enough.
You see that breaking ball, little backdoor curveball. Watch Gerald gets the ball. Oh, no, that ball hit right off the heel of his glove before he hit the wall. Watch him coming right there.
Oh, yeah. I thought he had the ball in his glove and then banged up against the wall and dropped it, but that's going to be an error charge to the right fielder. So it's not a base hit, and rightfully so after we see it on the replay. But the Yankees do pick up the run, and now it's 6-0. This is Scott Brosius.
When you look at the Yankees line, 6 runs, 4 hits. And Bobby, that's how they've done it all year. They can either hit you with the long ball, or they get you with the stolen base, or tonight they got you with the walk.
Well, good ball clubs, you played on good ball clubs, and they take advantage of everybody else's mistakes. That's how they beat you.
Absolutely.
And I remember the Baltimore Orioles in the early 70s when they had that great ball club there. We played them. Every time we made a mistake, they took advantage of us. Guys like Brooks Robinson, Belanger, David Johnson, Boog Powell, Blair, Frank Robinson, Buford. Tough play, and Rocker will let it go foul. Well, let's take a look at the game summary brought to you by Jeep, the most awarded brand of 4x4s on earth. And it's been all New York as they lead it 6-0. O'Neill got it started with a two out. But I checked that two RBI triple. Raines with an RBI single. Curtis with a two-run home run. Martinez scored in this inning here. The Gerald Williams error. And the Yankees are still not through. And David Wells is pitching another great game for the Yankees.
And he's getting his gloves on, ready to hit.
He's getting ready to hit. he hits behind Girardi, so he knows it takes him a little bit of time to get ready, so he wants to prepare himself. It's easy. I think it's easier to take the gloves off than it is to put them on, okay? Off to the left side. And Brosh is playing souvenir baseball here at Turner Field.
One of the things, Bobby, that the architects have done in these new ballparks is they've made them like the old ballparks. We see right there very little foul territory. And all the old ballparks, Ebbets Field and all them, they're very, very little. You foul the ball off, and it's generally going to go in the stands and give the batter one more whack.
Well, they have the fewest foul ball outs here at this ballpark, and I like that too, because I want the fans. I'd like to see the fans get as close to the action as they can. Rochus will swing past that fastball as he strikes out. The Yankees are down here in the seventh. They pick up one more. We go to the bottom of the eighth inning. They lead it 6-0.
Chrysler in Plymouth announces the Owner's Bonus Sale. These unbeatable savings are also extended to all GM and Ford owners. Select customers save $1,750 on America's lowest-priced minivan, Plymouth Voyager, $2,000 on Plymouth Grand Voyager, or $2,000 on the ultimate minivan, Chrysler Town & Country. And when you choose our low 1.9% APR, you still get the extra $1,000 owner's bonus for a limited time at your Chrysler and Plymouth dealer.
You see, David, I feel your feelings betray a feeling I felt about your feelings. And I felt our feelings had grown beyond feeling this way. What you felt...
Let's face it, you're not always clear on a cellular phone. But now there's Sprint PCS, the only nationwide all-digital network for a new level of clarity.
I'm going to Mexico with Brad.
Sprint PCS.
It's only for 2 weeks.
The clear alternative to cellular.
Both these men have athlete's foot, but only one used the soothing cure. Prescription strength Desinex. It calms the itching and cools the burning while it heals. Got athlete's foot? Get Desinex, the soothing cure.
With its 150 horsepower engine, luxury appointed interior, power locks and windows, and standard CD player, the Nissan Altima is like getting a five-star dinner at a takeout price. The Nissan Altima, the affordable luxury sedan.
Lease the Altima for $229 a month for 39 months. Initial payment, $999. Ends June 30th.
New York!
New York Yankees baseball is sponsored by Nissan, to remind you that life is a journey, so enjoy the ride. Swain now will go in to play first base, and I think probably that's more of a precautionary for the New York Yankees. Ricky LeDay will now go in to play left field for the Yankees. Martinez in the last inning was hit by a rocker pitch in the back, so taking no chances, I'm sure Joe Torre, along with Gene Monahan, take him inside, ice it down to...
Well, you've got a big series coming up with the Mets, and you don't want to lose Tino Martinez for 3 games just to play him 2 innings in a 6-0 game. And Dale Swaim can play first base and get the catch all the balls that are going to be hit over to him. And hopefully David Wells can get 6 more outs, if not the bullpen can.
And the new hitter is Eddie Perez, pinch hitting at the bottom of the eighth.
Now Eddie Perez is the second and last catcher on this Braves ball club. But I would imagine they have an emergency catcher.
And David Wells pitching here in the bottom of the eighth inning. He has fallen behind Perez, 2 balls and 0 strikes.
That was David Wells' 100th pitch. 75 of those pitches are strikes. That's pretty good pitching. No, that's not pretty good. That's very good pitching.
Really. And that's in there. Now it's 2-1.
They got pitching machines that don't throw that many strikes.
How important is it to the Yankees, Joe Torre, or the David Wells, Dennis Martinez now beginning to warm up for Atlanta, to pitch a complete game? Is it that important?
I don't think it's that important personally, but you would like to do it just to dispel the myth that you aren't in shape, that you wilt in the heat. And I think David Wells would like to prove something.
Well, David Wells has been running around this Turner Field all night long, and he has changed his T-shirt. He's got another, looks like a dry T-shirt on now.
David Wells falling off the mound to third base side and having to run over to first base. Plenty of time, but then you see him talk to Mark Hirschbeck right there, showed him the ball and said, Mark, can you do something for me here?
Thank you. He's going to be a tired puppy tonight after this game. He's going to get a good night's sleep, I can tell you that.
You know, one of the things that happens when you pitch in the heat like this and you're on your flight back, cramps, leg cramps.
Yeah. Now the ground ball, Jeter has to back up on it. With a strong arm, will throw out again, and there's two gone here in the eighth. Yeah, immediately after this game, the Yankees will board their charter plane and fly back to New York.
Fastball up out over the plate. Now, usually when you back up as an infielder, you're in trouble, unless you have an arm like Derek Jeter. Backed up on that ball a step or two and then still gunned it and got Ozzie Guillen by two steps.
So now Gerald Wales will step in. Well, you're talking about cramps, leg cramps, oh. Especially when it's very hot. You got to make sure that you don't get dehydrated. You lose the lactic acid in your muscle parts and you begin to start to cramp up. So you got to drink as much water, or as much fluids as you can to try to stay away from that. And that's what Donahue and Gene Monahan do. They're right on top of it. So they'll be trying to pump those fluids, you know, into those players tonight who have lost a few pounds because of the sweating mechanism.
They like to give them, there's a couple pills they used to give with electrolytes in them that was really good for cramping. Take them with plenty of water.
High fly ball, shallow right field. And O'Neill calls off Knobloch. So Atlanta is gone. We've gone through eight, and the Yankees lead it 6-0.
Summer's here, and you can count on your Toyota dealer to make the most of it. Count on the mountains, the beach. Count on a Tacoma to get you there. And right now, you can count on Super June savings. Only $189 a month leases a new Tacoma 4x4 and all that comes with it. Or get $1,200 cashback savings on any new Tacoma. Count on great deals on the versatile Toyota 4Runner. Or a new RAV4, the compact SUV with big performance. Don't miss Toyota's Super June savings. Count on your Toyota dealer now.
What could the Bell Atlantic B2B be? Well, the B2B could be by the computer, for its thousands of area sales and service centers. Or the B2B could be by the office manager, for its endless list of suppliers and contractors. But the B2B better be by the boss, because it's filled from cover to cover with all the help you need to grow a business, whatever your business might be. The Metro New York and Northern New Jersey business-to-business buying guides, where business meets business, from Bell Atlantic.
Troy Aikman is back to pass. He's looking, look out. Oh, Aikman goes down.
He had a man wide open. What was he thinking?
Brute, it's all part of the game.
All right, guys, same play.
There's only days left to save big during the Great American Ford Sales Event at your Tri-State Quality Ford store. Only days left to lease an Explorer Sport for just $335 a month. Or buy an Explorer Sport with low 1.9% financing. Now's the time to lease a Ford Explorer Sport for just $335 a month or buy one with low 1.9 financing. But it all ends in just a few days. Get to your Tri-State Quality Ford store before the Great American Ford Sales Event is history.
New York Yankees baseball is sponsored by the Toyota Camry, the number one selling car in America, Toyota, every day. And by Brewery Fresh Budweiser, who reminds you fresh beer tastes better. By the company you count on wherever your life takes you, General Motors, people in motion. And by Nobody Beats the Wiz. Well, the Yankee flags are flying high here at Turner Field as the Yankees lead it 6-0. They come to bat here in the top of the ninth inning, and a lot of Yankee fans on hand, and they have enjoyed themselves the last two nights. And I think it even spills over as we go back to 1996 here at Turner Field.
El Presidente, 2-4, tied Juan Marichal with a complete game shutout for the most wins by a Latin American pitcher. Going to pitch the ninth inning. They counted him out, Bobby. How many times have they counted him out? And he came back this year and made the Braves ball club. Dennis Martinez.
Talk about somebody who has made an adjustment. His whole style of pitching is so different than what we remembered him as when he was in Baltimore, Cleveland. Now he's a finesse guy. You know, he's turning the ball over here. He's running the ball away. Got pinpoint control. That's what he's counting on. A semi-weak arm, Dennis Eckersley, when look at that ball move. Woo.
That was a good sinker. Watch that ball go down. Man alive.
Well, it's going down and moving right in on Joe Girardi, leading off here in the ninth for the Yanks. David Wells on deck, and he is ready.
And Dennis Martinez used to be up over the top a little more. Now, as Bobby said, he's kind of dropped down a semi-Dennis Eckersley.
You don't see the curveball from him anymore. You know, his trademark pitch was that curveball. Lined in the right field. Williams is there, one gone. But that, 12-6 curveball, that hard one that Martinez used to throw. And here comes David Wells. Wells batting for the fourth time. And he's still got that left pocket hanging out. Wells' line, a base hit in the third inning, his first time up. That was the first base hit by the Yankees. He struck out in the fifth and fly deep to right field in the seventh. Wonder whose bat he's using.
Hit his own model.
Oh, do they have their own models now?
No, but I just think that he might have.
Chopper right side. Husko steps on the bag, and there's two gone, and it'll be a slow walk back to the Yankee dugout.
When you swing the bat as good as David has, you have your own model. Well, one of these days I'll bring in the Tommy John model. I got a couple of those back home.
Are they just like mantelpieces or what?
No. Genuine game bats.
That you actually used?
Yeah, absolutely.
What, you do clean your cleats off with them or what? I'm just kidding, TJ, you know. But I don't think I ever saw you hit the ball hard.
Got five home runs.
Do you really?
Closed out Fred Stanley, Chicken Stanley.
Oh, it must have been when you were in the minor leagues. Is this major league stuff?
Major leagues, yes.
Knobloch on the ground to right side. Bonino will throw out Knobloch. David Wells will answer the bell here in the bottom of the ninth. He's got a 6-0 lead.
Jeep Cherokee has always been the perfect getaway vehicle. But now, look what you can get away with. The $279 a month Jeep Cherokee lease, where you get 190 horses, automatic transmission, and always capable four-wheel drive. Plus now these extras, including air conditioning at no extra charge. The $279 a month Jeep Cherokee lease. A great deal to get away with when you really want to get away from it all. Check out this $279 lease at your dealer.
It sounds like a summer party. It's Puerto Rico endless summer sounds. For this incredible low price, enjoy 3 days in Puerto Rico, including free breakfast. Plus, kids stay and eat for free. Don't miss the summer party. It sounds better than ever. Call Liberty Travel for your exciting, endless summer sounds vacation in Puerto Rico.
Both these men have athlete's foot, but only one used the soothing cure. Prescription strength Desinex. It calms the itching and cools the burning while it heals. Got athlete's foot? Get Desinex, the soothing cure.
At the age of 3, they have the endurance, stamina, and speed that makes a champion. Of course, we're talking about the car. Certified pre-owned by BMW, with protection up to the first 100,000 miles. All the car you ever wanted, for less than you wanted to spend. Stop dreaming, start driving. Available at your authorized Tri-State BMW Center.
Well, David Wells working on a shutout here in the bottom of the ninth inning. Now it's time to take a look at our GM turning point of the game. And it's Paul O'Neill. In the sixth inning, that's when the Yankees did big damage. But this was a triple into the gap right center field. Two runs will come on to score. And the Yankees will take a 2-0 lead at that point. turning point of the game. As David Wells pitching to Chipper Jones, leading off here in the bottom of the ninth inning. They have asked for the appeal down to first base. Hirschbeck says no. Jones did not go around. He's 1-for-3 tonight. High block throwing on Jones. One gone here in the ninth inning. What does this say to the Atlanta Braves from the New York Yankees? They come in here and
come into and their home park, them. And sweep them.
If they win tonight, and they've won three out of the four interleague games that they've played. But David Wells working on his complete game tonight, and also his 10th win. If he wins tonight, which it appears that he will, his record will go to 10-2, and the earned run average will certainly drop on this shutout. Joe Torre really loving this year, I can tell you. He's got a strong ball club, and they're looking for their 53rd win. This is Javi Lopez.
Javi Lopez wasn't too happy on that curveball, but on Chipper Jones, David Wells, a good, hard, high fastball, and then he threw him a changeup. A 6-0, and I know you hitters didn't like to see changeups when the team was ahead 6-0. But Wells threw him a changeup, and he just grounded weakly to Knobloch at second base. You know, it's one of those Lou Piniellas. Come on, challenge me.
Out of play. Talk about Lou Piniella most of the time against Larry Gura. Gura was one of those finesse guys. He wouldn't throw the ball hard, and Lou just couldn't hit him with a 10-foot pole. And Lou just used to holler out at him and say, "He hit me. You couldn't hurt me if you threw your fastball anyway. You don't throw it hard enough." In the meantime, Gura was getting Lou out every time. Inside for a ball. Now it's 2-2 on Lopez. One out here in the bottom of the ninth inning.
We'll see 2-2 pitch right there. He threw a changeup to Chipper Jones after throwing a high inside fastball. Let's see if he comes back here.
Romero Mendoza and Graham Lloyd warming up just in case. Hot for Swaim at first, and it's two gone.
That was a fastball away. Fastball inside to get the count 2-2. On a 2-2, look at that. Right on the outside corner, and Lopez grounded weakly to Swaim at first base. Boy, David Wells has just been magnificent.
113 pitches. 83 strikes and 113 pitches with two outs here in the ninth inning. Andrew Jones, the batter, and last hope for Atlanta. And the breaking ball.
David Wells' last shutout, 5-17. May 17th against the Minnesota Twins, 4-0. And a half of pitching.
That was the perfect game that he pitched against Minnesota. He struck out 11 in that game.
Well, I guess if you're going to pitch shutouts, that one was. Tell you what, this may not be a perfect game, but Joe Torre and Mel Stottlemyre will think it's an almost perfect game.
They'll think it was a perfect effort by.
You got that right.
And it's one ball, two strikes to Andrew Jones here with two outs in the ninth inning.
I tell you, David Wells has got to be considered, if not starting in the All-Star game, at least one of the pitchers on that team that's going to get some. In fact, the Yankees could have three pitchers on the All-Star team.
The Yankee fans here clapping, and there are a lot of them. They want Wells to strike out Jones. And he fouls the pitch and out of play.
How those Yankee fans get all those good seats down here?
Well, Wells looking to win his 10th game. David Cohn won his 10th game last night. They will have identical records, 10-2. Padded 8-5 on the year for the Yanks.
David Cohn could have a shot. 10-2 is a pretty good shot at the All-Star game. And then I think you've got to look at Mariano Rivera, one of the best relievers in baseball.
Lined in the left field, a base hit, so the Braves stay alive with two outs here in the ninth.
Fastball on the inside part, but not quite in as much as they've been throwing Andrew Jones. And that's a fatigue factor, too. You throw the ball, you're at about 120 pitches. And your heart rate is right now is about 120.
And Danny Bautista will step in. Joe will get a drink of water. And hope that Wells can get Bautista out of here. And he will. High fly ball, deep center field. But Curtis has got a beat on it. And the Yankees will shut out the Braves here at Turner Field by the score of 6-0. And what a game by David Wells, his second complete game of the year. The last one, the perfect game that he pitched against Minnesota. And he moves his record to 10-2. And in the American League, he will tie David Cohn with the exact same record and move into second place with the most wins. What an effort by David Wells this evening.
David Wells, a changeup. And Danny Bautista looking for a fastball, got out in front of it. And he got Chipper Jones on a changeup. And he got Danny Bautista for his 27th out on a changeup. Excellent, excellent job by David Wells.
Well, David did it all tonight, pitching, hitting, and defense. And he seemed to have a lot of fun doing all of it this evening, and rightfully so. Well, that's it from Turner Field. The final score once again, the Yankees shutting out the Braves by the score of 6-0. Please join us again Thursday at 7:30 as the Yankees play the Philadelphia Phillies here on the WB 11. Channel 11 News at 10, and coming up is the Channel 11 News at 10. And all the details following that incident. Versus New York in 1998, the only team with a winning record. Palmeiro will lead it off. Randy Velarde, the ex-Yankee, will bat second. Airstead batting third at first base. Salmon.
They'll be missing Troy. If you're looking for the definitive word on all today's action, you've called the right place, and so have you. So get a hold of yourself. It's SportsCenter, and it's next.
Again, thanks for letting SportsCenter flow side by side with Dave Revson. I'm Stuart Scott.
That is us. The greatest receives one of his greatest honors. Dave Steeb returns to the site of his greatest triumph and the greatest athlete of our times on trial. The details are all ahead. But first, shocking but true, we're going with McGuire and Sosa.
Can you believe it? Greatest home run hitters in the bigs. Greatest home run hitters in the bigs. Sheer numbers, 124 combined jacks, 279 RBI. You know, at heart, the leader of the free world is just a geeked-up sports fan. The first words of the phone call went something like this. Mr. Sosa, this is President Clinton. Sammy Sosa almost dropped the telephone. Bill Clinton told Sosa he's now a Cubs fan, and he put the presidential stamp of approval on a Cubs playoff appearance. Said Sammy, I do my best, I tell him. Mark McGuire's best Monday was his first two-single game in almost a month. I mean, sure, he's homerless in 18 at-bats, but Tony La Russa said, people are spoiled. I'm not. I'll take two hits. Cards played two games with Pittsburgh. Only 10,000 showed up initially when they heard Big Mac was out of the starting lineup for game one. Top five, Kevin Young in a 2-for-35 slump. Slump this. Three-run bomb is 25th of the year. Pirates up 7-4. Bottom five, J.D. Drew. One homer already. I'm not a player. I just crush a lot.
First Cards rookie in 7 years to have a multi-homer game. 16 career at-bats, three homers. Every 5.3 at-bats a homer. Better pace than McGuire. Speaking of.
Here it comes. Swing. High fly ball to left. 63 coming up, folks. It's at the wall and gone. 63 was lovely to see.
And it's been with a great Cardinal.
Take another look. You know, Tony La Russa put it best. Quote, he's been doing it for a year and 2 months. People cheering, come on, Mark. We want you to hit one, and boom, he hits one. How does he do it? I have no idea. Actually, Tony, it's booyah. He hits one, not boom. You saw McGuire give the old Cardinal congratulation with the future of the Cardinals organization, J.D. Drew. Pirates, they'll win the game 8-6. That homer, McGuire's 450th of his career, sixth career pinch hit home run. He's now two behind Carl Yastrzemski for 20th place all time. After fans gave back every homer from number 56 to 62, John Grass, who caught number 63, plans to sell it. He said, hey, McGuire makes millions of dollars. I don't think there's anything wrong with something coming to me. Come on, replied Big Mac. That's all right. He can keep it. After his pinch hit homer in game one, McGuire was in the lineup for game two, one up on Sosa, bottom one. Cards up one zip, Brian Jordan in second, McGuire facing Jose Silva. Big Mac, handle your business, kid. Lines the pitch into the left field corner. RBI number 133 as Jordan scores. Mac hustles in for his 20th double of the year. Cards up two zip. Top three, Tony Womack up with the runner in third. Womack flies out to J.D. Drew. Kevin Osick is going to test Drew's arm. I mean, brother's only been in the show a week exactly. Osick got played. Drew with the gun down 9-1-1. Check it out again. Osick appears safe, but he's called out. As for Drew, a fat doubleheader, 4-for-9, two homers and two doubles in the double dip. Bottom eight, bases loaded for Mark McGuire. The drama, the buildup, the walk. 154th time he's walked this year. RBI number 134 as Eli Marrero scores. Cards win 93. McGuire 1-for-3, two walks, two RBI in game two. Pirates bullpen just blew up, and I'm not talking about blew up in a good way. They blew up literally. Three innings, seven hits, five earned runs, five bases on balls. Cardinals have split all four of their doubleheaders this season. Mark McGuire now 13-for-27 with three homers and seven RBI against the Bucks this season. Afterwards, he talked about the pitch he hit out in game one.
He took something off it. I think it was just more of a, you know, he throws pretty hard, and it was a ball that I got to, and I think it was just more of a, like, 2 or 3 mile an hour slower than what the first three threw to me, and that's skied it. Nobody seems to want to give the pitchers any credit. You know, they always say, well, hey, you hadn't hit a home run. What's wrong? I mean, there's nothing wrong. And there's a guy on the mound I've said since day one that tries to get me out, and I see the best every day. And the majority of the time, pretty much over 70% of the time, they get you out.
Sammy Sosa's Cubs in a tie with the Mets for the wild card lead. Top four, no score. Sosa against the Padres, getting the standing ovation from the fans, but Kilby Oberis robs him of a base hit. Sosa 0-for-2 at this point. Top seven, Sosa at the plate again against Kevin Brown. Yep, yep, singles to right center. FYI, though, since mid-August of 97, Kevin Brown and the Cubs pitcher Kevin Tappany 1-2 in the major leagues and wins. Top seven, Mark Grace, as cool as the other side of the pillow. With Sosa on base, Gracie, his 17th homer of the year, a career high for Mark. 2-1 Cubs, top eight, 4-1 Cubs. Sosa up facing Brian Boehringer. Four Padre pitchers combined for 13 strikeouts. Padre fans trying to make Sosa feel at home, Waveland Avenue. Class act by the Padre fans. But Sosa goes down looking. 158th time this year, he struck out most in the bigs. Kevin Tappany hoping Rod Beck can close the door. Mark Sweeney, it was a big iron door right in Sweeney's mug. Beck's 47th save. Cubs win the game 4-2. Sosa does not get 63, but he is happy with the Cubs win. Kevin Tappany's 19th win is the most by a Cub pitcher since Greg Maddux won 20 during his 1992 Cy Young year. Tappany winning his seventh straight decision. I told you Rod Beck got his 47th save. He's done it in 53 chances. Kevin Brown now has lost three of his last four starts. Afterward, Sammy Sosa talked about not homering, but winning.
I had to say that Kevin Brown pitched a real good game, you know. He only made, maybe I had to say, one mistake. It was my great one here, a two-run homer. But beside that, we just happy we got the win today because Nero make win today.
We had some games earlier in the year where we came back, and I think some of the veterans that had been around here and on some other ball clubs, I think to a man, we all looked at each other and said, hey, that's going to come in handy somewhere down the road, and it certainly did. And I think a lot of those games early in the year that we played were character builders.
63-62. Big Mac breaks his six-game homerless streak exactly 1 week after he hit number 62. Sosa now 1-for-9 with six strikeouts in the Padres series. He gets two more games at the Q before returning to Wrigley for a weekend set with the Reds. Jeremy Schapp and Carlos Diaz and Jimmy Roberts have more on these two sluggers later on in this edition of SportsCenter. Dave?
In 1997, the Astros were 19-25 in games decided by one run, second worst in the NL. This year, they're 28-16 in one-run ball games. 47 of their club record-tying 96 wins have come after they trailed. Eight of those wins have come in extra innings. Why are we boring you with all the random facts and figures? Well, it's a literary device known as foreshadowing. Astros and Mets, game one of a twin bill. One day after, the Stros clinched their second straight division title, and huge crowd on hand to celebrate, actually. Filled up to more than 40,000 by the time game two was over. Jeff Bagwell, Craig Biggio, Derek Bell all kept out of the starting lineup. Top of the second, Mets down 1-0. Shane Reynolds on the hill. Ray Ordonez, a two-run homer. Just his third career homer in more than 1,300 at-bats. It's 2-1 Mets. That is cause for celebration. Top of the ninth, they're down 4-2. Lenny Harris on first. Carlos Baerga, a two-run shot. His seventh of the season. We're tied at four. Larry Durker. Stunned. Baerga 4-for-5. Just two homers and 15 RBIs since the All-Star break. Bottom of the ninth, we're tied at four. Pinch hitter Mitch Molusky, the single to left. Tim Bogart tried to score, but Jay Payton says, how dare you? Great throw by Payton. He's come back from elbow surgery. And then Todd Hundley, good job to hang on. Top of the 11th, two outs. Runner on second, still tied at four. Ordonez to right center. Ralph Milliard scores. Ordonez sliding in with a double. Drove in three runs of the game. It's 5-4 Mets. Bottom of the 11th. Jeff Bagwell leading off, taking John Franco deep. Number 33 on the season, ties it at five. Bagwell 2-for-2, two RBI. Later in the 11th, Biggio flies out to center with two runners on, and Biggio not pleased. He hates that dugout wall. Biggio 0-for-3. Top of the 12th now. Runners on second and third. Two outs. Tied at five. Jay Paul to Brian McCray. McCray 0-for-5 after his Monday heroics. Bottom of the 12th now. It's Derek Bell up close and personal. And Derek Bell, the solo shot to end the ballgame. Number 21 for him. And that is it. The Stros take it 6-5. And the replay confirms what we already suspected. That was the game-winning homer, and afterwards, Bell says, oh, my God, as he watches that one leave the park. Stros win it in their final at-bat for the 26th time this season. 6-5 once again, the final. Jay Powell, who pitched a scoreless 12th, picked up his seventh win. Despite the Mets' loss, the light-hitting Ordonez, the big-hitting star, the homer, his first since September 2nd of last year. As for game two, top of the sixth, Al Leiter and the Mets down 3-2. Leiter getting some D. Ricky Gutierrez, slow roller to third. Edgardo Alfonso, bare hands, and then guns out Gutierrez at first. Gutierrez 0-for-2 in the game as we look at it again. Alfonso, good game at the plate, too. Went 2-for-3, and Gutierrez was bumming. Top of the eighth, Mets down 3-2. Two runners on, John Olerud. Off Mike Magnotti and Olerud. A three-run homer. It's 20th of the year. It was 2-for-14 lifetime against Magnotti coming in. Olerud 1-for-1 with four RBI, and the Mets dugout fired up about that one. They are up 5-3. Bottom nine now, Mets up 8-4, but the Stros threatening. Two runners on, Turk Wendell to Jeff Bagwell, lining to Carlos Baerga, steps on second, and there's your ball game. The Mets do indeed get the split, and Turk is pumped. Oh, yeah. Why did the Stros get the works? That's nobody's business. But Turks, the Mets salvaged the split with that 8-4 win. Al Leiter improving to 13-2 in his last 18 starts after winning his fourth straight decision. Biggio singled in the ninth to become the first Astro ever to get 200 hits in a season. That the only hit off Turk, who left Bobby Valentine impressed.
What more can you say about Turk Wendell coming in like that? I think he's pitched 100 days in a row, and he keeps going out there, and he saved the day for us.
I've just come into the ball games lately kind of with like a new attitude. We got 10 games left, let it all hang out, and I just keep telling myself, throw every pitch as if it's going to be my last, because it just might be. And, you know, we need these games.
The Giants loses a 4-5, continuing their three-game series in Arizona. Top of the fourth, 3-0 Giants. Runners on first and third for Sean Dunston. And Sean makes it 6-0 in a hurry. His third of the year, only hit of the game for Sean. And Mari Telemaco, he would get yanked after allowing six runs in the fourth. Bottom of the sixth now, Dunston.
Dunston
doing it defensively. Great diving stop on Andy Fox. By the magic of videotape editing now, we take it to the bottom of the 11th. Runners on second and third. We're tied at six. Travis Lee coming through off Jose Mesa, bringing home Andy Fox. Lee one for six, but the one was big as it won the ball game for the Diamondbacks. 7-6 is the final. The Giants continue to struggle. They lose for the fifth time in their last six. Diamondbacks bullpen stellar. 7 2/3 shutout innings, giving up just one hit, one walk, and striking out five. So here's what we have in the wild card hunt. The Cubs win. Mets doubleheader split means the Cubs are back on top of the NL wild card race by a half game over the Mets. The Giants have now lost two straight in Arizona. They are slowly falling out of this race. Mets have one more in Houston Wednesday. They're off on Thursday before returning home for a five-game homestand. The Cubs have two more in San Diego, then return to Wrigley for their final three home games of the season.
One play, symbolic of a season. Monday, eighth inning of a 2-2 game. Angels double race Tim Salmon and his shredded foot ligament on first. Todd Green smokes a double to left center, stopping at third base. Not an option for Salmon, who said, "I would have run through the stop sign." About his bum foot, Salmon remarked, "You do a quick inventory after that play. Is everything attached? Can I still walk?" That's why the Halos have 43 come-from-behind wins and a two-game AL West lead, and they're at Tampa Bay again. Salmon, top four, Angels down one zip. Rolando Arojo tells him, "You ain't got to go home, but you got to get up out of here." Salmon 0-3 with an RBI. Arojo, five strikeouts. Bottom five, Devil Rays up one zip. 2-1, Trenton McCracken cracks the ball off Jeff Juden's foot. Craig Shipley cannot make the play. Rich Butler scores. McCracken, former Duke football player, 2-for-5. Next batter, Wade Boggs, right up the gut. Miguel Cairo scores. Boggs, two hits, two RBI. D-Rays up 3-0. Still bottom five runners at the corners. Jeff Juden uncorks a wild throw pass first. McCracken scores. Juden gave up six runs in five-plus innings. Devil Rays win it 8-1. Rolando Arojo's 14th win sets the record for wins by an expansion pitcher. Still, it is Arojo's first home win since June 17th. As for Anaheim, next up, they begin their set with the Texas Rangers. This is what Terry Collins said. Every radio show, every writer, nobody cares about anything but Texas. Well, bottom line, Wednesday we go head-to-head. There are no secrets. Speaking of Texas, Rangers trying to gain some ground at Baltimore. Rookie Chris Fussell's major league debut, 14th starter the O's have used this year. That was his dad. Top two, two out. Todd Zeal, full of sound and fury, signifying nothing. Fussell, 5 Ks on the night. He said later, "I went out there and did my best." Bottom three, Cal Ripken being a bomb diggity. 14th of the year, 345 for his career. It's a 12th homer Esteban Loaiz has allowed in the last 8 games. Top six, 5-2 O's. The thrill is gone. Will Clark beats out the infield single. 98 RBI this year by thrill Will Clark. Rusty Greer score, top nine, 5-4 Orioles. Milt Kiler in first. Pudge Rodriguez, mid up, mid up. Pudge's 19th homer of the year. He said later, "I just tried to hit the ball hard. I got a hanging slider and I hit it out of the park." He hit it off of Armando Benitez. Rangers win it 6-5. Juan Gonzalez got his 152nd RBI, most in the majors since Tommy Davis had 152 ribs for the Dodgers back in 1962. With the win, the Rangers move to within a game of Anaheim for first place in the West. Wednesday, as I say it, they open a two-game set with each other. We'll have a preview of that later in SportsCenter. As for this one, John Wetland worked the ninth for his 40th save. He's one of only four pitchers with three or more 40-save seasons. And it is on. Angels, Rangers, separated by one game. Jumpstart a two-game set Wednesday. That game's on ESPN. Shameless plug. It'll be Chuck Finley against Todd Stottlemyre. These two teams also rub shoulders in a three-game series next week.
In the Cowboys' season opener against the Cardinals, Troy Aikman ran for two touchdowns. For Troy, those two rushing TDs were a personal high for a season. But the joy surrounding Aikman's newfound ground game came to a crashing halt Sunday against Denver when Aikman broke his collarbone after a scramble. On Tuesday, doctors told the six-time Pro Bowler that his injury won't be completely healed for 6 weeks.
Very painful still. A lot of discomfort. I'm not wearing the sling. They said that was just more for comfort for me, which it wasn't providing. So I'm not wearing that. But I'm still obviously limited in what I can do and just kind of taking it day by day until some of the pain subsides and the swelling goes down and I'm able to get out and be a little bit more active with it.
More injury news. Ravens starting free safety Kim Herring out 2 to 4 weeks with a dislocated left shoulder. Herring suffered the injury when he tackled Wayne Krabet in Sunday's win over the Jets. And Redskins kicker Scott Blanton is now former Redskins kicker Scott Blanton. He was waived on Tuesday after he missed 2 field goals Monday against San Fran.
There are things in life you just have to do, like the time I took my daughter, who was then just a year and a half old, to New York, wrecked her sleep schedule just so she could meet Muhammad Ali, just so he could hold her. I'd do it again. Still ahead, a huge, well-deserved honor for Mr. Ali. Also up, will the defendant please rise? Michael Jordan in court and will be in court because, as his attorney says, he doesn't run away from things. Manny Ramirez blowing up. Manny, a big jack attack against the Blue Jays. And lost to the Maguire Sosa madness, Ken Griffey Jr. just jumped into the record books again. You are experiencing the strength of SportsCenter.
Milwaukee's best.
There is cotton that feels as soft and innocent and pure as a newborn chick. We didn't use any of that kind of cotton.
Design right in front of the kids to see what they think. I click on that guy right up there.
That's cool. Linda, yep. We need help.
Kids are great with computers because they'll tell you exactly what they think.
That's strange.
Whoa. The other thing you want to do is be able to collect these cards along the computers way. Are great for kids because they have infinite patience.
I want to do it.
That's a good thing.
One official Major League Baseball. $9. New ball, $9. New ball, $9. New ball, new ball, new ball, $9. New windshield, $100. 62, priceless. There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's MasterCard, official card of Major League Baseball and believer that records were made to be broken.
The last time Dave Steeb took the hill in Cleveland, he pitched a no-hitter. Of course, the last time Dave Steeb took the hill in Cleveland, the Indians played in Municipal Stadium. John McNamara was their manager. Ken Phelps started for them at DH, and Bud Black opposed Steeb on the hill. Point is, it's been a while, 8 years to be exact. Steeb in the starting rotation due to Pat Henkin's shoulder problems. Steeb and the Jays starting the day 3 games back in the wild card race. Bottom of the third, 4-3 Jays, Manny Ramirez. This would be a recurring theme in the evening. Number 38 for Ramirez, solo shot, 426-foot job. We're tied at 4. Bottom 5, still 4-4, and it's deja vu all over again. Steeb, Ramirez, 2-run shot. We'll do the math for you. That's number 39. It's 6-4 Indians. Bottom of the 7th now, 6-5 Indians. Steve's out of there. Paul Quantrill's in, and it just doesn't matter because Ramirez is doing it again. A solo shot. Yes, that's number 40. Third in the game, all in consecutive at-bats. 5 RBI on the night. 24th three-homer game in Indians history at 7-5 Tribe. And Ramirez knew this one was gone the whole way. 7-5 Indians the final. Ramirez becoming just the sixth Indian ever to hit 40 homers in a season, joining Albert Bell, Rocky Colavito, Al Rosen, Jim Thome, and Hal Trotsky. This was Toronto's second straight loss. So the Bo Sox a chance to extend their wild card lead to 4 games, visiting the Yanks. Hootie and the Blowfish on hand. Great seats, everybody. Top of the second, no score, 2 men on. It's Mike Jarzembic to Jason Veritek, and Veritek takes the Queens native out. His 6th homer of the year, a 3-run shot. Bo Sox up 3-0. Veritek, 2 homers, 5 RBI. Bottom of the third, 2 men on, 2 out. Red Sox up 5-0. It's John Valentin. Nice play to rob Bernie Williams. Bernie 1-for-4 in the game. Bottom of the seventh, 9-0 Red Sox. Chili Davis lines it to left. It's Trot Nixon, the former first-round pick, making the dive and catch. Chili 0-for-4. Top of the ninth, 9-4 Bo Sox. Mariano Rivera to Veritek. Lines it off Rivera's mitt. He would be okay, but the Yanks would not, as the Red Sox snap their 3-game skid with the 9-4 victory. Boston winning for just the third time in its last 12 games. As for the Yankees, they have now dropped 9 of their last 15. The AL wildcard race shaping up thusly. The Red Sox win coupled with the Blue Jays loss means that Boston's now up 4 games on Toronto. The Red Sox reducing their magic number to 9. Texas is 4.5 back, although their primary focus is that AL West race, where they are 1 game behind Anaheim.
Watching Ken Griffey Jr. playing with his young son, Trey, both of them hats turned around backward, the reality slams into you like a jackhammer. Jr. really doesn't care about records. As he said a few weeks ago, when you were a kid and you went 0-for-4 and your team won, you were still happy, you still went for ice cream afterwards. So go tell somebody else that Jr. with 1 RBI would be the 4th youngest guy to reach quadruple digits in RBI. M's at Minnesota, top 4, 3-2 Seattle, bases loaded. Jr., break me off, Liz, 7-7. Jr., 28 years, 10 months, Shane Monahan, Carlos Guillen score, RBI number 1,000 and 1,001. Only Mel Ott, Jimmy Fox, and Lou Gehrig reached a grand quicker. Top 7, 6-4 Seattle. On a one-hopper to right, Matt Lawton, who hit his 19th homer in the game, comes up throwing. Raul Ibanez and first base umpire Dave Phillips collide. Phillips had to leave the game. Still in the 7th, 9-4 M's. Eddie Guardado's 1-2 pitch to Griffey just missed on the corner. Guardado wanted the call on Jr., who came in hitting only 192 against Minnesota. 2 pitches later, don't hate Eddie, congratulate. 3-run shot, 52 for Jr., a 5 RBI day, 132 RBI for the year, said Alex Rodriguez. He's amazing, unbelievable, the best I've ever seen. And Guardado had one of the best yelling fits I've ever seen. And then Tom Kelly comes into his defense. Guardado got ejected. Kelly got the boot for just the 3rd time in his career. Kelly said later, I had to go out and protect my pitcher. What Eddie did was wrong, but I'd have been more upset if he didn't get upset. Twins lose the game 12-7. Jr., no special plans for RBI number 1,000, 1,001, 1,002, 1,003, 1,004. I'll get a call congratulating from my dad and my mom, and he'll ask where the kids are. I'll tell him Seattle, and he'll say, talk to you later. One more cool Jr. fact. He needs one more stolen base to join Willie Mays and Brady Anderson as the only players with 50 homers and 20 steals in the season. Not that he cares. As our producer Rob Gujarat would say, this just in, Ken Griffey is good. Just 10 days older than Gehrig was when Gehrig reached 1,000 RBI. You know, when the Twins, Matt Lawton reminded people Monday night that Jr. was hitting just 192 against them, the Twins said, don't say that. Don't wake him up. Jr. woke up. More baseball. This is all you need to know about the White Sox loss to the Tigers. One night after the two teams combined for 33 runs on 41 hits, they combined here for just 2 runs on 13 hits.
Still to come on the show, we'll take you back to St. Louis for more on Big Mac's latest big night. And a little controversy in Detroit as Scott Mitchell tries to bounce back. You're immersed in Sports Center.
The politician's idea of economic development is giving your tax dollars to favored businesses. Real economic development is the byproduct of a well-managed state. My solutions? Keep budget increases in line. Pay down our record high debt. Educate our young people for the future, including training for technical jobs. I am qualified to provide the leadership for this important undertaking. That's why I'm running for governor.
Let's hire Tom Golisano.
This time, it's not about the belt. It's not about the record book. It's not about the prize. This time, it's personal. Oscar De La Hoya, Julio Cesar Chavez, ultimate revenge. live on pay-per-view, Friday, September 18th.
NFL Tonight on ESPN2, Tuesday through Saturday at 7:30 p.m. Now, guys will have something to talk about.
The aptly named Sunday Night Football comes your way Sunday night on ESPN. It'll be the Eagles and the Cardinals, 8:15 Eastern Time, right after NFL primetime. Then on Monday, the action switches to ABC. Emmett Smith trying to pick up the slack with Troy Aikman out. It's the Cowboys and the Giants, an NFC East battle from the Meadowlands. Monday Night Football, 8 Eastern on ABC.
The Detroit Lions, 0-2 after two games, haven't had much to joke about, but Herman Moore and Scott Mitchell were sharing a laugh Monday. Moore and Mitchell joking about an ESPN report that they had a physical confrontation in the locker room after Detroit's overtime loss to Cincinnati. Said Herman, "I don't know where that came from." Added Scott, "I didn't have any words with Herman, never have. Don't expect to." Now, even though they say they were not involved, there were some other players doing some shouting in the locker room after Mitchell's last two passes were picked off, the clincher being a 53-yard interception return for a touchdown by the Bengals' Corey Sawyer in overtime. Still, do not expect Bobby Ross to make any changes at quarterback. We've seen the future, and his name is J.D. Drew, but this bash is for the guy who has 50 more multi-homer games than Drew's first one he got Tuesday.
Ask 100 brewers and they'll tell you the same thing. Great water helps make the most refreshing beer. So do you think all brewers use the same ice cold water? Think again.
Alfred, come here. Run across the street. Check out what's going on over at Pizza Hut. Becky, run over to the Pizza Hut. Check on Alfred. Cece, Lou, Victor, check on Alfred, Becky.
Lou. No, you're Lou.
Anybody with a yellow shirt.
If you want the most exciting, most outrageous, most mouth-watering pizzas there are, you gotta go to Pizza Hut. The best pizzas under one roof.
They're not coming back.
We're in the best city, you don't skip.
Yeah, I am. Covers my body.
When governments need help.
Get the background.
Guy goes for the case.
Oh, they're good.
He's the first one you call.
Let's go!
And the last one you want to cross.
Car comes through here. Shooters across from each other. Kill each other dead.
Oh, my. Where'd you learn that?
But when everything goes wrong...
Get out of here.
Walk away.
He's the one who can make it right.
Thank you.
Academy Award winner Robert De Niro, Ronan.
Did you ever kill anybody?
I hurt somebody's feelings once.
Rated R. Starts Friday, September 25th.
The zoom lens. Indispensable for televising the three kinds of drives found on the tour. Those being wee, less wee, and freaking huge.
Aye, now there's technology serving mankind.
How do you seat 12 people on a Chicago jury who have impartial feelings toward a six-time NBA champ? Michael Jordan got a laugh when he followed protocol and introduced himself to the courtroom. Jordan's being sued for allegedly reneging on a deal to star in an obscure 1991 basketball film. MJ and his attorney say the producers lied about financing the project. The lawsuit seeks $20 million in damages. The movie, which grossed less than $200,000, instead starred former NBAer Bo Kimble. Said one attorney, doesn't have the same ring, does it?
On Monday night, Mark McGwire broke out of a 1-for-14 slump with a 2-for-4 night, but he didn't quite give the people what they wanted to see. Well, he was in a giving mood on Tuesday, breaking a 6-game homerless drought. Jeremy Schapp witnessed it in person.
It took 37 years for 61 to fall, but 62 didn't even last a week. Still, to Mark McGwire's amazement, for some people, even that was too long.
I think we spoiled you guys. you know. You know, I mean, you know, I just play the game. I'm going to swing the bat if I get balls to hit. You know, I've been pitched pretty tough, but nobody seems to want to talk about that.
The last time the single-season home run record stood for a shorter period of time was in 1921, when Babe Ruth needed 6 days to increase his total from 58 to 59. The 7 days between McGuire's 62nd and 63rd home runs didn't quite shake the world, but they did shake up the home run race.
I can only take care of Mark McGuire. I can't worry. And if I'm going to sit there and look at what he does, I'm taking myself out of my game, and vice versa with Sammy looking at what I'm doing. He takes care of himself, I take care of myself, and that's the way it is.
For now, Mark McGuire is again the undisputed home run champion of the world. But as the season dwindles down to its final days, he says he'd have no problem if in the end the record belongs to Sosa. After all, records are meant to be broken, sooner or later. In St. Louis, Jeremy Schaaf, ESPN.
Jeremy, thanks. You can see McGuire continue the home run chase Wednesday night on the Deuce. Big Mac and the Cards hosting Pittsburgh at 8 Eastern. That's followed by Barry Bonds and the fading Giants trying to stay in the wild card race as they face the Diamondbacks. It's all Wednesday, and it's only on the Deuce. In the interest of equal time, we'll head west after a break to check in on Sammy and the Cubs as they move back on top in that wild card race. Stay with us on SportsCenter.
When the heat starts to bite, do you have what it takes to bite back? Gatorade Frost. Is it in you?
They come from all over for the most agonizing test of endurance motorsports has to offer. The heavyweight championship of off-road racing. The legendary Baja 1000. Mile after mile of unforgiving terrain that can send even the toughest truck to an early grave, which means it can really be murder on a battery. That's why more drivers who tackle the Baja rely on the Duralast battery than any other. The same Duralast we stock at AutoZone. The Duralast battery. Power you can depend on.
What's my prize? Simple. To create a sports magazine readers love.
Big Mac 62? Is this the greatest moment of sports history? You tell me. And look out for Oscar De La Hoya and the 1-2 punch that knocks the ladies off their feet. Print it, baby!
This was more than a three-time heavyweight champ trading a pair of red boxing gloves for a small gold dove. This is one of the most important heroes of the 20th century, being recognized as the United Nations Messenger of Peace. Muhammad Ali's wife, Lani, said the gloves were symbolic because everything in life is a struggle. Ali recently visited Cuba.
For years, the Cubs have been saddled with the burden of having made one of the worst trades in baseball history. Lou Brock for, among others, Ernie Broglio. It's becoming apparent they may also have made one of the best deals ever, trading George Bell to the crosstown White Sox for Sosa back in March of 92. Bell was out of baseball 2 years later, and Sammy, well, he's good. The Cubs are good, too. Back in the wild card lead after Tuesday's win, Carlos Diaz has more.
With two out in the top of the ninth, Padres fans were not cheering for relief pitcher Scott Sanders to strike out Mickey Morandini.